Okay, children, now we will do activity 25 of mental maths. You please go through the first question. The first question tells that you have to fill in the correct number of days for each month. So I have written the names of these months, and below it we have to write the number of days for each month. Okay, so how we are calculating it, we are calculating through our knuckles in the fingers. What are knuckles? First let me show you. This is my hand, you can see. Okay, when I make it a fist in this way, this is called fist. Okay, when I make it a fist like this, then what I will do, I will start from the leftmost knuckle here. Okay, this, the raised portions are all having 31 days. These raised portions, and there will be some gap between each raised portions, that will, those months will be having 30 days. Only February month is having less, that is 28 or 29 days for leap year. Rest all months will have 30 days or 31 days. Okay, so we will start from the month of January. January will come in the raised part here. Okay, after that not raised part, that is your February, then the raised part again March, not raised part April, raised part that is May, not raised part it is June, and then comes July. So we have January, March, May and July. These months will have 31 days. Okay, and we will have February here. This is the shortest month of the year. It will have 28 days for the common year, and for leap year you will have how many days? 29 days. And then you are having this March. March is having 30 days. June is also having 30 days. After July ends here, make the fist of the next hand. Next hand, keep it connected with this. Okay, you will get two raised portions next to next. Means after the raised knuckle here, ending one, and here you will get the starting raised knuckle in this hand. Means this both days will have 31 days. Means July, after that comes August here. So August will also have 31 days. Okay, children, the next comes what? After August, what is the next month? September. September will come in not raised ones. Then you have in the raised knuckle, you will have what? October. Then not raised November. Then comes December. Again, it will start from the next, that is January, where we started earlier. Okay, in this way, for the 12 months, you can calculate in this way. Okay, now let us write down. So, January 31. February, I am writing 28 or 29. March will be 31, because this is 31, every alternate you will have 31, this is 30, 31, 30, 31, okay, after July, next to next, this is also 31 days, September will have 30 days, October will have 31 days, November will have 30 days, and December will have 31 days. In this way, we will write the correct number of days for each month. Now come to the next question. It is convert the following into days. Okay, let me do the first one. The first question, that is question number 2, bit A. The question is 6 months 3 weeks equal to 6 months 3 weeks. This is 3 equal to dash days. How convert into days it is asking, so it will be dash days. Tell me what will be the answer here. First of all, when the name of the month is not specified, remember this thing, whenever the name of the month is not specified, that time you have to take the number of days as 30. It is the default number of days for every month. Okay, so we will take 1 month equal to 30 days, and 1 week is, you know, it is from Sunday, Monday, Tuesday up till Saturday, that comprises of 7 days. So 1 week equal to 7 days. Now children, 1 month 30 days. So what about 6 months? 6 months will have 6 into 30 days. That's equal to 6 threes are 18 and this 0 will come here. So it will be 180 days. Now we come to 1 week. 1 week equal to 7 days. But here how many weeks are given? 3 weeks. So you will have 3 weeks equal to 3 into 7 days equal to 21 days. Now we have to take out the total of 6 months and 3 weeks. That is 180 plus 21. What is 180 plus 21? Equal to 8 plus 2, it will be 10, carry 1, 221, 200 or 201, because 180 plus 20 is 200 plus 1, 201 days. So, here in the fill up also, you will write 201 days. Now, let us move to the next question. That is your bit B. Bit B is June plus July. Children, how many days does June have? I have shown you through my knuckles. Here the name of the month is specified. So, exact number of days you have to write. So, June has total 30 days and July has total 31 days. So, 30 plus 31 makes 61 days. So, simple. Now, I hope you have got an idea how to solve these kind of questions. So, rest of the questions of question number 2, please solve it yourself. Okay. And question number 3 also, these are also very general questions that you should try. Okay. You can study the calendar of the present year and you can answer these questions. Children, remember present year means 2020. You have to see the calendar and you have to answer these questions. Okay, children. Only bit C, you see, this year you didn't had any summer vacation. Okay, so please mention that we had no summer vacation this year. Okay, children. Again, I'm reminding you. Question number 3, bit C. We didn't had any summer vacation this year. So, you please specify there no summer vacation. Okay. And if you have any doubt, we will have a class tomorrow. We can discuss. Okay. Thank you.